The hair is what it is. Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, get used to that. If you're new here, my name is Teresa Hurado, and today we're gonna do the alphabet makeup challenge. I've seen this trending and going around, but I never actually watched a video of anybody doing this. Last night, because I wanted to do this video today, I watched Nikki tutorials, kind of like skipping through. I didn't watch like the full thing, so I'm hoping it's as easy as it sounds. Like, I'm pretty sure you just do your makeup in order of the alphabet. Like brows before eyeshadow, like in order. I have it all in my phone and listed in alphabetical order, so we're gonna try to do that. So obviously, the whole challenge of this is that things are super out of order. I'm looking at my stack of makeup right here, and we're starting with blush. So I think that's the right one, blush. It's gonna be interesting to see how this makeup actually turns out. Eyeliner before eyeshadow, I can see that's gonna be an absolute disaster. But I thought this would be kind of fun. I'm gonna bring in a couple new products, try and make this look really good. I wanted to film another video today. I guess that will be determined of how well I do in this challenge. So if you guys are interested in seeing me try the alphabet makeup challenge, then keep watching. So as I was making this list, I feel like there might be a little bit of room for error depending on how you refer to some products. So just an FYI, if mine are a little bit of different order, I tried my best. I did follow the alphabet. I know how to do alphabetical order, but in case I called something anything different, we'll see. Just because I haven't watched other videos, I'm not sure if I'm gonna do anything like that wrong, but whatever. Let's start off with blush. Okay, so I'm gonna be starting off with the Maybelline Master Glaze by Face Studio. This is a cream blush. I have bought this, I don't even know how long ago, and it's one of those purchases that was a little bit pricier. It's their Face Studio, which I feel like is a little bit more pricey, and I bought it to do a video on, never did it. So I'm gonna get some use out of this right now. I'm gonna just put this like right here. I've never used cream blushes. This makes me look like I'm having an allergic reaction. Oh my goodness. More, maybe? Will that help make it worse? I don't know. Actually, it kind of looks like I'm sunburnt a little bit. Pretty color, just not right now. Oh, we'll just like bring it up here. I don't know. I never put blush on my forehead, but some people do, so I guess that's the thing. We're gonna do it right now. All right. I look a little sick. That's okay. So I had here bronzer, but I was a little confused in my thing because I do contour, which was a C. So I also have a cream contour. So I don't know. We're just gonna use this Too Faced Bronzed Peach Melting Powder Bronzer. This I don't really like at all because it came broken. Yeah, I probably could have written to them. I didn't. I just kept it. Whatever. Just use like a flat brush and that. I think I've used this one other time. Oh my god. It's a little sparkly, so it kind of turned me off, but hopefully it works right now. It smells good, I'll give them that. I feel like I should use really dark so that it shows under my foundation when I put that on. Should I try and go hard? Like, I'm just making myself look like a really badly painted doll right now. Okay, let's try that. So light though, so it's like, I don't even know if this was worth it, trying to make it darker. Oh, this is looking terrible. It's so splotchy. Okay, whatever. It's as good as it's gonna get, okay. Brows are next. I'm gonna be using the NYX Fill and Fluff in Brunette. This is my new favorite thing. I just recently did a promo with them. This is not sponsored or anything. I just fell in love with it, so. Gonna use this guy. I rarely, when I do get ready with me's or anything like that, do I include the brows because it takes me forever to do the brows and I feel like I waste so much time in the video, so I usually do this alone. But for this video, you get to see the process. So it's like a pomade and I'm just using this really like soft brush and blending it out, and it's just like so easy. And it's also because it's a pomade, it's like waxy. It is, I don't know if you can see the side. The hairs, my hairs go straight down, which is super annoying. So I kind of have to like sweep them this way. And I do use a brow gel, but this also gives a little bit of extra hold because of the waxy pomade. So I really like that. We can't cut our eyebrows yet because we didn't use the concealer. But I think that's coming up really soon. I think we're on the C's almost. Pretty good. So then what I go in and do is use my good old Gerard Cosmetics Brow Bar to Go, which is just a brow powder, and I'll just fill in a little bit more. Got this thing, I don't even know. As long as I've had Bruce, I've had this forever. I'm just gonna use a brow gel. even though I haven't cut my brows out yet, whatever. I don't think we can go back in the alphabet, right? Like I can't go back and use any products. I have to just keep going. I don't know the rules to this. I've been playing the game, I don't even know the rules. The next thing is concealer. I'm gonna be using the Tarte Shape Tape. I just felt like using something different. This is not my choice, my concealer of choice, only because I think I got the wrong color. I think I got like a too light of a shade. I usually go for the LA Girl Pro Matte Foundation. I know it's like using a foundation instead of concealer, but it works. So that's what I've been using. I just need to try this in a different color, but we're gonna use it today because I'm getting bored using the same stuff. I guess I'll put, hold on. Let's do this first. So I need to, I wanna try and keep some of the blush. How is that gonna work out? I don't think it's gonna happen. People who do color correcting, why would the blush show up? Because you're supposed to be applying foundation and concealer to cover a color correction. So why would my blush show up? I'm gonna have to almost skip any face stuff there. You love a textured cheek. I'm gonna use this to kind of carve out my brows. I don't know, am I allowed to use multiple concealers? Because I don't like using liquid concealers to carve out my eyebrow. I just feel like they're way too watery, but whatever, that's a lot. Can I use toilet paper to wipe off some excess makeup, or do I have to wait for the tea? Blend that out. Oh, we got this, this is fine. I think I'm pretty happy with them. I think they look decent, so let's move on. I had contour as the next thing, but I feel like that's super repetitive after the bronzer, so I think I'm just gonna skip that one because I still have whatever that did going on, so I think more would just make it worse at this point. So eyeliner. I'm gonna be using the H2O Proof from Wet n Wild. You guys know how I feel about this guy. If you watched my favorites video, how we're having issues. We're going through some stuff, so. Still gonna use it though, cause still love him. Although this is like completely gonna disappear, so I don't really know if I should be drawing it so big or it's just gonna turn gray, either or. It was like how I used to do my makeup in like high school, just nothing else but a thick black liner. All right, so I think this is dry. So we're gonna move on to eyeshadow, which I'm gonna be using the Burn Book, the Mean Girls from Storybook Cosmetics. I absolutely love this guy. So we have a bunch of colors in here. I was gonna do a pink purplish eye. I feel like I could probably do that. I feel like the darker the eye, the easier it is. Rather than trying to do, I don't know if I can do a cut crease because I need concealer. I don't know. I'm gonna start off with, she doesn't even go here. I'm using this Pixie brush, which is like my favorite thing ever. You can even buy this. I don't know why, because they sent it in PR and I fell in love. I was so excited, gonna share it with you guys. And then I went on their website to find a link and they don't sell it. So I don't know. But I really, really like this brush. Okay, so like, look how fast the brush is. Boom, color. Do I need more? Why am I doing, I realized I'm wearing yellow. Oh, me. We'll change. That's fine. I'm gonna try to like, go like that. So I'm gonna be taking Wednesday, which is this bright pink color in the middle here. Just try and put it right over top, not getting it on the eyeliner. And then just blend it up into my dark purple. Think we can do it, guys. Think we can do it. Probably need another brush to get really close. I'm gonna take a flat brush and try to get right up to that eyeliner line. There we go. I don't wanna go over my eyeliner. Some people can wear no eyeliner and it looks so good. I can't. I cannot. I need eyeliner. And then I guess we'll try the other eye. Now we're gonna try something a little more advanced. I think I'm getting cocky, but I really wanna put this Regina George, this light pink shimmer. I wanna put that on the inner corners, like halfway stopping. That's kind of been, I don't know, I feel like I've been obsessed with doing that lately, but I feel like this one especially will benefit from that since I couldn't really blend it out the way I wanted to, so we're gonna try that. So my eyeshadow completely covered my eyeliner, so I think I'm gonna look for a black eyeshadow to like cover it up because it's looking really bad. Okay, let's do the under eyes really quick. I'm just gonna take my fluffy, like dense brush and I'm gonna go into, I'm just gonna do the pink, like the hot pink color. Ooh, super pigmented. Getting all over my face. Dang it, I just did this. Maybe I'll put a little bit of that dark color closer to the line. The weirdest technique ever, because you usually want to do your eye makeup before you do your foundation and face makeup. Well, I did it the opposite way, where then I only did the face makeup that my eyeshadow would get on before I did the eyeshadow. My favorite part, finally, is foundation. I feel like I'll feel much more myself once I get this done. I'm gonna have to do this very strategically. I don't want to cover the beautiful bronze we have going on. I don't need this much. Why am I drawing this much on? Oh, this fixes everything. Not cover this bronze either. I think I covered the bronze. My hands, this is like such an odd technique. Get away, foundation, get away. Let's see, what you wanna do is just like chip away at your foundation. I may have been wrong about this fixing everything. This is fixing nothing. The next thing is highlighter. We're gonna try the Jeffrey Frost Supreme Frozen Peach Highlighter. Why not? It seemed like a good time to try something brand new. Obviously, do not judge the quality of this product by what we're seeing today. I don't even know. I haven't set anything because that's S. Although I could have maybe put that in with the F's, like a face powder. I don't know. We're going set in powder, so I haven't set my face at all. So this highlighter, I don't know what it's gonna do. I mean, it's looking really nice. I mean, yeah. All right, let's try this side. All right, I just need the nose to come out good. That's all I want now. Okay, and then let's do like the inner corners, all that jazz. Try to make our eye look great. Eye look, I'm actually not too mad about. I think that looks pretty good. The eyeliner. Lashes are next. Okay, we're holding our breath. I'm gonna be using the set of Ardell lashes mixed with, I think they might be the Social Eyelashes. Whenever I create a little duo concoction, I just keep them together and I don't like save the boxes. I probably should, but I usually either end up losing them or they somehow like get stepped on or get stuck to someone's clothes like when I take them out at night, because I don't sometimes put them where I'm supposed to, so. Then they get destroyed, so I usually don't have them for too long. So unfortunately, I don't know the exact concoction I made up, but they're my favorite. So I'm gonna be using the Duo Eyelash Glue, the dark tone. Ooh, eyelashes could have been E. Although that would have been way worse. That would have been way worse. I just called them lashes. Is that not correct? I put them with the L's. So the next thing is a lipstick. My lips are doing so bad today. Ugh. I was trying to drink water. It didn't work. I try and load up on water for 30 minutes. Just like, go to my lips. But it did not. But I have here this CoverGirl Caramel Kiss lipstick, which I'm pretty sure I'd never wear alone. But let's see. The next step, because that's done. We're just gonna go with that. Mascara, which I'm actually really happy to do my bottom lashes. I'm not gonna do the top lashes. I feel like I'm the only person who does not do this, but I do not like running the mascara through both my lashes and my false lashes. I'll put top mascara on before I put my falsies on, but I will not do them together because I feel like they totally ruin my lashes. The amount of product that gets clumped on there, if you do it every single time, eventually your lashes start to look piecey. And I guess you could clean them. I don't actually clean my eyelashes. I don't know if that's super bad, but I lose them before I really need to do that anyway. But I just do not like running mascara through my falsies. So we're just gonna do the bottoms. Using this Neutrogena, I think it's the this is the Almay Multi-Benefit Mascara. I like this one too. All right, that is now finished. The final step is setting powder. I am going to be using, let me get this eyelash glue off. I'm gonna be using the Derma Blends Illuminating Banana Powder. Absolutely love this. I'm running out, I need to get some more. I'm just gonna take a little bit here. I feel like this is going to complete the look, I hope at least. I mean, there's good and bad parts about it, I guess. I'm just gonna put this where I would normally put my setting powder. You can't really bake too much. I mean, I feel like the oven's already gone off by now. I had this sitting on my face for so long. I don't really think the baking is gonna do anything, but at least we can just set it all, make it look nice and matte. I like a nice matte face, except where I put my highlighter, which I just forgot about. So I guess we won't set my nose too much. I guess count to like 10. I don't really know what this is doing. Then I'll wipe it off. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, my poor highlight. Okay, so this is the finished result. I'm liking the brows, I'm liking the eye, and I think that's it. I think the face looks very flat, and we have some natural texture coming out on my cheeks. Real skin isn't bad, obviously. It's just funny next to the plastic looking skin I have here from my very full coverage foundation and concealer. So here we are. What do you guys think? Which do you think came out good? Which do you think did not come out good? Did I miss any steps? I don't think I missed any. I mean, I don't really use a setting spray, and I wouldn't right now because I'm definitely 100% taking the face off. I think I'll leave the eyes on, but I'm taking the face off for my next video. I don't need to set this anymore. I feel like my camera's gonna make it look pretty good, but no. thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope it was somewhat entertaining. And if you have not already subscribed, definitely subscribe and hit the notification bell so you can be alerted when I put out a new video. I will see you guys in my next one. Bye!